maíz, tomate, café, coca, el tabaco, se siembra 50,000 plantas al año.
So every year they plant 50,000 tobacco plants, all right? But it won't be the only production that they have every year. So besides tobacco, when it is not tobacco season, they also have like yuca, potato, sweet potato, actually corn, and also coffee.
En septiembre, a la orilla de los ríos, de las presas, se prepara la tierra y se echan los semilleros de tabaco.
So the tobacco process goes like this. It begins September, so they are going to prepare like the land. The land has to be nearby rivers, and they are going to put the seeds in that area, the tobacco seeds. Esta es la semilla del tabaco, so this is the seed of tobacco. It is the second tiniest in the world. La segunda más pequeña del mundo.
So what do you mean by second finest? Second finest means there is
other area. Tiniest, smallest.
I see.
This is the seed of the tobacco plant. Yes.
He
says that in my hand there will be like 5,000 seeds if someone wants to count them.
Oh wow.
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 Cuando los semilleros tienen 45 días, que las plantas miden de 10 a 12 centímetros, se empiezan a trasplantar hacia los campos.
So, in the seed beds, after 45 days of being the seed, inside the seed bed, the plant will have reached like from 12 to 15 centimeters high. So, in that time, 45 days later, they're going to move that plant to the fields outside.
En los campos están 3 meses, hasta el mes de febrero, que mide unos 40, unos 50 de altura, y se empieza la recolección de arriba hacia abajo.
So in the field, they're going to stay like for 3 months. And by that time, the plant will have reached around 1.50 meters high. It will be like this high. Okay, so in that moment, they're going to begin like the harvesting. So the harvesting is going to be from the top of the plant, bottom, they're going like to pick leaf by leaf, okay? Wow. And bring it inside this place, a tobacco dryer.
Cuando se recolecta, se trae aquí el secadero, y aquí en el secadero está 3 meses, hasta el mes de mayo, que empieza la lluvia.
So, this is a sample of how the leaves are put inside the tobacco leaf drying house, okay? So here they're going to stay live for 3 months. The place is going to be full of leaves, okay? And then in May, they're going to bring down the production.
En el mes de mayo, cuando empieza la lluvia, el tabaco se pone blando, flexible, húmedo, y se hacen estos pequeños paquetes.
So in May, in Cuba begins like the rainy season, humidity increases, and then the leaves become like very soft and easy to handle. So they're going to bring down every single leaf and they're going to make these packages.
Con estos pequeños paquetes se pone la madera donde se cuelga en el aposento del medio y se pone con el tallo para afuera y la hoja para adentro y se tapa con la yagua de la palma durante 45 días cogiendo la fermentación.
So these packages that they are going to prepare for fermentation. So first fermentation is going to take like 45 days, okay? So they are going to cover the packages with the bark of the palm tree, which is like a natural humidor. And they are going to pile up all those packages in the middle of the barn house.
A los 45 días viene la empresa Cuba Tabaco, el gobierno, por el 90% de la producción y el 20% del campesino para la fuma un tabaco artesanal.
Okay, so after that fermentation time, the Cuban enterprise, Cuba Tabaco, is going to come here. They're going to buy 90% of their production. And the local grower, they're going to keep like a 10% for local cigars.
¿Alguna pregunta?
Do you have any question?
Sí, porque lo cogéis de arriba abajo en lugar de abajo arriba. Cuando lo recogéis de campo.
Se recolecta con el tallo y todo. De abajo para arriba es cuando se ensalta la, aguja con el libro y aquí se corta con el tallito, que es a donde está la...
So he was asking why the harvesting goes from the top to the bottom. And he says because here they also get, I mean like this, how do you call this?
The stem.
The stem. They also collect the stem with the leaf, so they have to begin from the top to the bottom.
Entonces, no se hacen cierros durante todo el año.
¿Cómo?
Se hacen cierros durante todo el año.
Claro. Sí. Hace una producción, se colectan las hojas, se producen.
Pero se puede hacer durante todo el año.
Sí, la producción, sí. Por la siembra es una vez al año.
Vale. Pero luego durante todo el año se van haciendo puros una dos.
¿Una planta? ¿Cuántas hojas da?
12
hojas. Cada 7 días, cada 4 días de la semana se hacen recolecciones. A una misma planta.
De abajo para arriba. De arriba para abajo, por completo. El campesino, con la parte de él, le quita todo el tallito y se queda con la hoja y lo prepara para una segunda fermentación.
So, the local growers, they're going to remove, they're going to cut the stem and they're going to do a second fermentation process to the leaves.
La fermentación se la hace con miel, ron, la hoja, la guayaba y el nepio central de la hoja. Eso lo hace con un té, con una infusión y lo rocea con un spray y lo pone dentro de la yagua durante 50 días para que le dé el gusto, el sabor, el aroma para poder comerlo.
So, to that second fermentation, they are going to provide some kind of aroma to their own cigars. So, it's going to take like 50 days, and they are going to prepare like infusion, okay? And infusion is going to be made of guavalis, honey, some rum, and also the main nerve of the plant. They are going to spray that on the leaves, and then they are going to let it to ferment, I mean, for 50 days. And after that, leaves ready for rolling cigars.
Una pregunta.
Any questions for?
¿Cuánto el gobierno paga
por un paquete como ese?
Por la calidad.
He says it depends on the quality of the
leaves. Y la calidad, ¿quién la pone? En aceite hay unos catadores, en vino.
La calidad la tienes pues por la calidad que tenga el tabaco. Y te pagan por la calidad que tenga el tabaco.
¿Pero quién?
El gobierno.
Hay un catador que dice este es categoría 1, categoría 2.
Sí. Entonces vamos a hacer la demostración cómo se utiliza.
So now he's going to show you how cigars are rolled. So come closer so you can see and record. Acérquense para que puedan ver. Asegúrense que todos vean bien. Can you see? ¿Ven bien? Córranse un poco hacia acá, ¿cierto? Hacia la derecha.
Ahí salgo al 75% de la nicotina.
This is the main nerve of the leaf, so holding 75% of the nicotine, so it is completely removed, okay?
Se
utiliza como un abono, it is used as a fertilizer.
Thank you.
esto que se utiliza por la suegra.
And the machete will be for his mother-in-law.
Se compone en tres partes: capote, tripa y capa.
So a cigar needs to be done from 4 to 5 leaves, and it is comprised of 3 parts. So this will be the filler, it will be the area for burning. This will be the binder in order to combine these leaves, and the leaf over here will be like the wrapper, okay?
Se pone en una prensa en un molde de 20 a 30 minutos.
So in the factories, usually they're going to put the cigar that just made into a presser from 20 to 30 minutes for shape.
Y el mejor tabaco se tuerce en los muslos de una mulata.
He says like the best cigar is rolled in the tights of a mulata girl, like my skin color.
Bueno, no daremos ideas.
Then it is ready.
Yeah,
está listo. Someone wants to try? Are you sure? Seguro? No desean probar?
I'll try it. My first one.
Okay.
Okay.
Over here. Okay, so some tips about smoking cigars. First of all, you don't inhale the smoke. You just try it, you leave it in your mouth, and then you breathe it out. Okay.
Bueno,
algunos consejos para fumar el tabaco. El humo no se traga, es como el cigarrillo que se traga y se inhala. Se deja en la boca, se saborea y luego se exhala.
Hola.
Hola.
Oh, God.
Okay. What do I do?
Okay, I can keep. Oh, great! Thank you.
You can just pass it over.
Oh, pass it.
You can finish it. Y que prueben. ¿Alguien más? ¿Seguros?
Great.
Oh,
no.
No.
Oh, wow.
Color like that.